Hello, everybody. It's me and all the ponies, and welcome to Glasswing Capstone. So, I'll be testing out this build. Hang on. Ugh. Okay. So let's be doing this. Whoop. The graphics. I'm sorry if I don't talk so much. It's because I'm so freaking tired, but I want to play this through so badly. That is basically the description of an animal. Soka. Hmm. Oh, right. That is so disturbing. Okay, so here's the thing about Lord Ferris's character that I can't understand but don't completely agree on. I feel sympathetic towards him because he has been like he's going through some form of depression, I think, from losing so many of the ones he cared about, and he wants to like stop it all, and like I can completely understand that, but he could have handled it differently. Like he was so desperate to fix the problem that he didn't take into consideration of there being a Glasswing who isn't like capable of like isn't mentally capable of handling that situation. Like Mayfly is pretty, she's self-conscious, I think, like insecure, at least that's what I get from her like aura or something. And like she was dragged into a situation that she could barely comprehend. And he must have noticed Mayfly's, at least Mayfly's, discomfort with being there, and like this thought of her like losing the one thing that makes her a Glasswing. Like that's one of the only things that makes her like her, and taking such a big chunk of her is probably mentally scarring. So like I was told, like on the Facebook page, it said that Mayfly would never be the same after her adventure, and I completely understand that. She'll basically be traumatized from the experience. So basically Ferris sort of ruined her life. Well, not really ruined, but changed her life for kind of worse. And she gets to learn the truth of the world that she thought she knew. It's pretty depressing. But still, I like that Mayfly is now having more personality than she had in the original game. She didn't really show any emotion in the original game, but here you can see that she is scared and worried and confused. But despite all that, she's still strong to keep on going. She may not be like physically strong, but she is mentally and like maybe emotionally too, sort of. Oh, and here comes the part that I hate the most. Mayfly's first encounter with a mindless monster. I really love the sound effects in this game. It's really improved from the original. There it is. Now, I'll be muting like my own sound so that I won't be so stressed out. But here we go. Literally YOLOing it. Darn it. There we go. Man, the music is also pretty perfect. Because now Mayfly is starting to realize the truth of the world that she lives in. It's pretty tragic, but, you know. It's actually a very true to life itself. Like, when you grow older, you start to realize the truth of the world you live in. And while it's not pleasant, it's something we all gotta realize sooner or later. Mayfly, she was just probably so... like, isolated in her, like, calm village that she wouldn't even consider the thought of, like, all this. Man, I'm very tired. Oh boy. YOLO. Hey, dude, come here. Come on, dude. Come on. Come here. Come and get me, glitch. Whoop. See ya, sucker. All right. Man, this is quite impressive. It's a lot more open than the original game. And probably even in the retold version. I'm very impressed. And I'm seriously freaking tired. I almost didn't get any sleep last night. I was too busy being in freaking despair from watching my street. She may not be like physically strong, but holy darn, Mayfly is just the smartest, because like she actually thinks of doing this. She is brilliant. Another reason why I love her. Sorry about that, I had to eat something. Well, the tree sounds are the same. It's at least a lot better. Oh, hey. It's a feather. Whoa. Pretty cool. Oh shoot. Here we go. Come on, this sucks. die. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. I'm gonna die. Not this way. Nope. Yep, I'm dead. Okay. I managed to do the part. Stealth wasn't really my strong suit, so it took me a little while. But anyways, now we're here. Let me tell you, when I first played this, like when I first tried this, and I came to this part, I knew exactly what was gonna happen. Like there was something familiar about this area that I remembered in the first, like in the original game. And I walked around here and I thought that all the time. Like, I know what's gonna happen. I know what's gonna happen. Like, this is the part. This is the part that scared the heck out of me when I played the original game. And in here confirms it. Right there. If you guys ever saw me play the original Glasswing, you know this part. The weapon, or rather the tool, surrounded by three lives. Or in this case, live flowers. And the moment I picked up that weapon, the music changed and, well, exactly. Shoot, here we go. Try to do my best. It's not gonna work. I will escape. I will run. Come on! Come on! Don't do this to- No! You missed it! Okay, this is the new part. Is this? Flower pots. How cute. Whoa. This is kind of disturbing. What the hell? An impenetrable wall? Sayuri did say that this was supposed to be that of an abandoned factory. And I can see that. It's a little bit weird and kind of creepy. How the hell am I gonna? Oh, wait. The impenetrable ball doesn't go up there, so I can just use the new move I've learned to get up there. Whoa. It looks so weird, but also very cool. You can hear now in her voice that she's starting to like. This spider here makes you heavier so you can break it. It's actually kind of funny. Huh, this spider went away. Well, that was actually pretty cool. Wall jump. Bye, little spider. Whoa. Hey, can you help me, little buddy? Thanks. What is this? Hey there, little buddy. I guess two of those spiders can't hug my boots. Do. Must the second one hug my boot as well? But how in the world is it going to hug my boot? Oh! Ah! Now I'm so heavy I can't even swim! Oh! Sayuri, you genius. She sounds like a robot underwater. Yo, she's gotta be strong if she can carry those spiders on her boots. Shoot. Come on, come on, come on, darn it. I don't like creepy music. This game is so interesting. It's a real work of art, that's for sure.
Mm.